I decided to talk about the first 100 days of the Trump presidency and see how Donald Trump compares to our past president, Barack Obama. I'll be focusing on three main things: executive orders, controversies, and approval ratings. The first 100 days of the Trump presidency is littered with controversies, ranging anywhere from false statements to travel bans. 3 days into Trump's presidency, Sean Spicer, the press secretary, tells a lie about the size of the crowd that attended Trump's inauguration. Alternative facts is a term that was used by Kellyanne Conway, the U.S. counselor to the president, used during an interview in early 2017. She was defending the false statement made by Sean Spicer about the number of people who attended Donald Trump's inauguration. Conaway said Sean Spicer gave alternative facts. Chuck Todd, the interviewer, responded with, "Alternative facts are not facts, they're falsehoods."
They're saying it's a falsehood, and they're giving Sean Spicer, our press secretary, gave alternative facts to that. But the point.
Wait, what?
Alternative is defined as a choice limited to one or two more possibilities. A fact is defined as something that actually exists, reality, truth, something known to be true. In the statement Conaway made defending Spicer, she said, going by the definition, that Spicer gave a possible truth, which is true, but it was found that Spicer's alternate fact was indeed a falsehood. Spicer and Conaway are not the only two in the first 100 days to be the center of a lying scandal. According to the Washington Post, 492 is the number of false and misleading claims made by the president within the first 100 days. That's an average of 4.9 claims a day. 10 is the number of days without a single false claim. On 6 of those days, the president was golfing. And 5 is the number of days with 20 or more claims: February 16th, February 28th, March 20th, April 21st, and April 29th, his 100th day in office. According to an article by CNN, President Trump signed an executive order on January 27th to keep refugees from entering the country for 120 days, and immigrants from 7 primarily Muslim nations out for more than 3 months. The countries affected are Iran, Iraq, Syria, Sudan, Libya, Yemen, and Somalia. This ban included even green card holders and valid visas. People flying into the country at the time of the ban were turned away after landing and sent back from where they had just come. This led to many upset people and lawsuits. This order was not cleared through the Justice Department. Homeland Security knew very little about the matter. Between this and the lawsuits coming from upset individuals who had been banned, the executive order was temporarily blocked. The only thing that I found in doing a Google search for controversies surrounding the first 100 days of the Obama presidency was an article by PolitiFacts. This article talked about 6 of the 514 promises made by President Obama during his campaign, and how those 6 had been broken in the first 100 days. Of the 6 promises, 3 were about taxes, 2 about transparency and ethics, and the final one is about deals with international diplomacies. According to Business Insider, during the first 100 days of the Trump presidency, he made 32 executive orders, while President Obama made only 19. Donald Trump started his presidency with a 45% approval rating, and since then has dropped to a 42% approval rating within the first 100 days. While according to the New York Times, this is the lowest approval rating since before Dwight D. Eisenhower. Obama started his presidency with an approval rating of 69%, which dropped to 66% after his first 100 days in office. In conclusion, the evidence shows that Trump's first 100 days have not been a success. Obama had fewer controversies and a higher approval rating during his first 100 days than Trump. and it is always a good policy to check the facts. Not alternative facts, the actual facts. Thank you. Obama's my man. Obama's my boyfriend. Banned by the executive order was temporarily banned. We're gonna cut that whole thing. That was a bad one. What you say?
Plus two is five. Frederick Douglass is still alive. Vladimir Putin had nothing to do with those hacks. Alternative facts. I was quick to condemn the Ku Klux Klan. My executive order's not a Muslim ban. They were clapping in New Jersey for the 9/11 attacks. Alternative facts. I tell you, up is down and black is white, and every little thing is gonna be alright. The truth is gonna be whatever I say. Call me Mango Mussolini or just Il Duce. I really care about working class folks. Global warming is a Chinese hoax. Three Doors Down is one of our greatest rock and roll acts. Alternative facts. No, Mexico is gonna pay for that wall. My great big hands can bomb a basketball. And when my audit's done, I'll tell you what I paid in tax. Alternative facts. Can you believe this crowd? 1 million people in the studio. Play one for them, Stevie. Up is down and black is white, and every little thing is gonna be alt-right. The truth is gonna be whatever I say. Call me Mango Mussolini or just Il Duce. My thoughts and prayers go out to Bowling Green. I'm the least racist person that you've ever seen.
So Obama's my boyfriend. We've been dating for like maybe 9 years now, almost 9 years, I guess, or eight. It's not getting too serious because he's still with Michelle, but I can see a future with it. It's going some places.